Oh, what the hell? Why did you just hit me?
It seemed like a good idea at the time.
For God's sake.
What is it?
I don't know.
Ooh.
It's addressed to us.
Sounds like a film.
Hopefully it's a good one. Oh shit. When cycling through the city at night, and it don't abuse a parking lot, I've got my fingers greasy and you didn't care. I was fixing your shade while you're fixing your hair.
We've had a late addition and a late request, even though Fan Appreciation Month has already ended. I just want to get this over and done with as quick and pain-free as possible. This is 2008's The Women.
The Women centres around a group of women, shock, I know, who are very rich and have loads of time on their hands, so they do anything any rich woman with loads of time on her hands would do by going to salons and going to fashion shows and things like that. So our main character is played by Meg Ryan, who has a family and a daughter and all that other stuff, but she soon finds out that her husband has been cheating on her.
You're a bad man. You're a very bad man.
But he's not just been a bad man. He's been playing away with a perfume seller.
The spritzer girl?
Yeah, can you believe that?
So her friends come to her aid and help her in this tough time. So this is based on a 1930s film, which is also based on a stage play from the 1930s as well, but this version has been modernized with technology!
Get in!
So shop the first floor. Go!
A cybernetic organism, living tissue over a metal endoskeleton.
However, there is one thing that it does manage to keep from the original, and that is, there's no blokes in it.
Nope.
Now, when I heard this idea that there was no blokes whatsoever, I thought, oh, there's going to be one in the background, or oh, there'll be one sort of pottering around somewhere, or a couple. But no, when I say there's no men, there are no men whatsoever in this film at all, and it's quite amazing to see, because you usually tend to, like I said, you would expect at least one or two just slip in there somewhere. They're mentioned, but they're never seen, and it was really bizarre. It was like something out of the Twilight Zone.
Maybe the affair was no big deal. Maybe treating it that way actually is the more modern thing.
When did you become French?
I'm not sleeping with him, so
good. Make him suffer.
This was a really interesting one for me. Well, how I found out about the film was I read online somewhere that it got 13% on Rotten Tomatoes, which is a poor score, a very poor score. Considering the original 1930s version got a score of 90%.
Eh?
Yeah, it got 90%. 90%! So why does it score so low? Well, one of the main things that really griped me was the dialogue. Good God, was it just not realistic at all. I mean, there's a bit where one of the leading women is talking to Mary's daughter about things.
How old were you when you had sex?
Careful now.
30. It was horrible. It hurt like hell. And it was totally embarrassing because we had no idea what we were doing. We were up in his room one night, big Farrah Fawcett poster staring down on the bed, Star Wars sheets. It was tragic. I didn't have sex again for a really long time. But then I met somebody, and it was worth the wait. We were crazy for each other. And then magically, and it was all really easy.
So basically you're telling me exactly what my mother would say if I could even ask her. Don't have sex until you're in love.
No. No, I've had pretty great sex, just for the hell of it. I won't lie to you.
Now, call me crazy, call me stupid. I know you all do.
Call me kooky, call me wacky.
Exactly. But you just wouldn't talk to a young girl like this. I mean, I know she's trying to be honest with her about things, but you just wouldn't be that honest. It's like she's saying, go on, kid. Go and sleep with loads of men. It's all for fun. It'll be fine. Doesn't matter if you get pregnant a couple of times. It's fine. It just wouldn't happen. There's times like that where you're just absolutely screaming at the screen and going, oh my God, why? Why are you doing this? Why?
There's honest and then there's taking the piss.
Exactly. But then when there's times you're not screaming at the screen for whatever reason, you just... bored. I got so bored watching this. Because the plot, yeah, the main lady gets to be cheated on by a fella. It's a plot which has been used time and time again. It just seems so tired to me now, and it's just boring. I mean, I know there's the theory out there that there's only 7 stories in the world and nothing's ever original, but there's always new things that they can bring to the table in these 7 stories, and this just doesn't do that at all. No. Let's take another woman-related film, for example, that we have coincidentally reviewed. Let's look at Sex and the City, for example. So, what do we have in Sex and the City? We have 4 female characters, very high-powered female characters. What do we have in this film? 4 high-powered female characters. Isn't that a bit of a coincidence? And in Sex and the City, we have Carrie Bradshaw being dumped by a man at the altar. Sure, this film didn't have her being dumped at the altar, but she's been pretty much dumped by a man, so it's a very similar story. Doesn't it sound very familiar? So, it's just ridiculous. To go back to dialogue for just one quick second, you can see by the way I'm dressed, I'm not a fashionable person. I'm not hip and trendy and all things like that. But when these women were speaking in the film, I couldn't help but just look and just think, what? Are you talking English?
You knew and you didn't tell me? Right now, honest to God, Mary, I'm so hurt.
You?
Yeah.
You, this isn't happening Mary, to you. This is happening to me.
But wait, I may have expressed a lot of negativity in this, but there is a tiny nugget.
A tiny nugget
of positivity I can give to this film. It's only tiny, mind, but there, Mary's daughter, I got really sympathetic towards her because she's going through this tough time where her parents are getting a divorce and the parents are arguing and all stuff like that. So I can understand it must be quite hard for a child to go through that. But then my sympathy just went straight out the window as soon as she started saying things like this.
No, that's like 5 points.
Since when are you counting calories?
Since I'm fat. Is there anything I'm allowed to do? I do it so I won't eat.
Your weight is fine.
I hate my body.
I know a lot of young girls at the moment are talking like this because they're stupid and they read fashion magazines, but I can't help but think that sort of behaviour tends to stem from the mother, really, because all the daughter will see is the mother's whinging, oh, this isn't right, you know, my body's too fat.
Yeah,
I felt like going up to Mary and going, shut up, for God's sake. Think about your daughter before you being so self-centred and so childish.
Yeah.
So just grow up, will you, woman?
Grow a set of balls.
Exactly. Well, it is Meg Ryan.
Yeah.
But... to sum it up, it is It's a very painful film to watch at times. It's not as eye-stabbingly painful as I thought it was going to be, as other reviewers have said. But on the majority, I got very bored because of this tired, lackluster plot that I have seen countless times. And I just think it needed a couple of extra rewrites before hitting the screens.
Go on. I've been looking forward to this. From the outset, I was angry. Angry at how pro-female and man-hating this film seemed it was going to be. And it really didn't disappoint on that front. Which, to be honest, was the only front it didn't disappoint on. About 6 minutes in, I actually wished pain and suffering and death on every single person that had spoken in this film so far.
Well, you know what he says? I hate people.
I hate people. Especially people in this bloody film. It's just horrible. I mean, there's a part in it where one of the main characters, little girls, says to the wrinkly old slag as she comes into their house.
No way!
They love you.
They love you.
Dora!
Trust me, kiddo. I feel your pain. I hate you for making me watch this film.
It's not my fault.
But not as much as I hate the people in the film which you made me watch. This is why some people shouldn't make films. It probably didn't help that while I was watching this film to be reviewed, my missus was watching Married with Children on the telly. And I know it's a DVD of a sitcom from the 80s, but I'm pretty certain at one point Al Bundy shot me a look of disgust for watching this yeast-pleasing pile of drivel, which was on the screen. After 20 minutes, I've never had this in a film before. I actually wondered how much paracetamol and vodka we had in the kitchen. It was that bad. Oh, yeah. Apparently, this film cost something like, I think it was, how much was it? It was like $15 or $16 million to make. What the hell, right? It grossed 28.6 mil in America. But it made, I think it was £685,000 in the UK, which fills me with national pride, as the gals of our country have got better taste than to just subject themselves to this god-awful drivel that Diane English threw together and slapped on the fraudulent title of film. Meg Ryan's character in this, who made me laugh because, to be honest, I couldn't take her seriously because she had hair like Robert Plant in the heyday of the mighty Led Zeppelin. She turned to her mum at one point while having a dinner and uttered the words,
"What do you think this is, some kind of 1930s movie?"
I wish this was a classic 1930s movie, preferably The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari, so Werner Krauss, he could get Conrad Veidt to go out in the night and kill the shit out of every single character in this film. I hated this film with a passion. It was just shite. It was awful. I think I've never walked out of a cinema before, but I think if I'd have seen this in the cinema, I'd have run screaming. And they'd be like, "What the hell? Like, don't watch the film, it's terrible!" I actually felt my eyes start to bleed. I formulated my opinion of the film as it limped painfully into the hour mark. And it's just bollocks and should be avoided like the plague. Instead of watching the whole film as it got to the last 30 minutes, instead I read an interesting article about Jurassic Park 4. Which is out next summer, which I'm quite looking forward to. So all in all, don't watch the film. It's a bubbling pile of poo.
Bubbling poo.
Bubbling poo.
Right. Ratings? If there are going to be any. I'll go first. As I said, it bored me more than angered me because of the tired plot. There are a lot of times where I was screaming. And let's be honest, I think this film does deserve a good hammer to it. But there was that tiny nugget which sort of saved it a little bit because I actually felt something for the film. Albeit 5 minutes, but I did feel a slight connection to the film. So I'm going to be kind and give it at least a one. But that's all it's getting. I'm not pleased to give it a one, but it's...
You're going to give it one.
Yeah, I'm going to give it one. But yeah, so one from me.
This film, as you said, had a little nugget of joy. This wasn't a nugget. This was the whole Cleveland Steamer, let's be honest. I'm not even going to... Can we give it minus ratings?
Can now.
I'm going to give it a minus 10 million because it was shit.
Okay.
And that's the most grown-up thing I can say about it. Minus 10 million.
Well, that's a one from me.
And a minus 10 million from me.
Well, that was The Women. And I can see what some audience members may be thinking right now is, you don't get it because you're blokes. Well, I did a little bit of effort for this one. I went out into the world full of the peoples.
The people that I hate.
Aye. And I got some women's opinions on the film to see if they could counterbalance what we've said. So, I'm not going to quote the Boots advert. Take it away, ladies.
Hi, Nicaea here. So, I'm an authentic woman and I'm here to give you my women's take on this movie. I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all. In fact, the movie kind of pissed me off. It's very poorly named because it has nothing to do with being a woman. It has to do with being a rich, privileged socialite, and therefore isn't authentic or real. I don't sympathize with the characters at all. I don't empathize with them. If this movie could have like a different title, it would be called First World Problems, the movie. That's what it is. Every shallow representation of women that could be represented is here. Like, it's funny because they're shallow and I love fashion and oh my god, nails and makeup and oh, counting calories and blah 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 blah. It's just like, oh god, really? Fuck you. It's so cute that her daughter thinks that she's fat even though she's skinny. Aw, how cute. Girls are so funny. No, fuck off. That's actually a real problem. This is what happens when people live in Hollywood in like these giant palatial mansions for like too long, is that just this lose touch with the actual culture. And I didn't like this movie very much. And yeah, I didn't like it.
This film is heinous. For a film that is about women, made by women and for women, it offends me deeply how vapid, useless and pathetic every character in the film is. These stories are recycled and dull, Hollywood fare. But I had to sort of sit through it in several sittings because I couldn't stand to watch it in one go, which has never happened to me before. If the characters were bland, that would be one thing, but they're so much more than that. They're stupid, they're shallow, they're annoying. They just don't make me want to care about them whatsoever. You've got Meg Ryan playing Meg Ryan, but older. She looks as though the Crypt Keeper skinned her alive more as a Halloween costume. Thank you, plastic surgery. You've got Annette Bening is insufferable as her irritating best friend. You've got Deborah Messing playing what I'm assuming is the film's interpretation of an arty person whose only goal in life is to pop out kids. Jada Pinkett Smith plays a lesbian, acting as though she's imagining how a stereotypical lesbian would act, and doing it badly. That the film, that they're all successful and rich, of course, they go shopping in their spare time. Just like the working class people this film was probably aimed at. But, Eva Mendes, she shows up too. Sexy Eva Mendes shows up to be sexy Eva Mendes. The man snatcher, that's her one dimension. Granted, she's the only interesting thing in the damn film. But the thing that really bothers me about this, about the woman, is that it just seems to really hate men. You got every character, her life revolves around a man in some way, and it's constantly bitching about that. But it just serves to make the women utterly loathsome. And if that's trying to be representative of what women are like, it's doing a really bad job of it. I get the feeling the director is a combination of all five characters and thought, hey, you know what? I can split myself into five people and still make an interesting story. Well, no. No, honey, you can't. Because if this is what is representative of my gender these days, then slap a dick on me and call me Steve, because I'm out.
This movie in particular, it catered to my girly sense of wonderment or whatever, in that I like girly shit. However, when I think about it logically, it is a pretty terrible movie and it does offend me deeply, to be honest. The fact that a movie about women has to always be about men. It doesn't always have to be about men, and it doesn't even have to be about children, which they always are. Why can't it be a group of women sitting around farting, making, you know, jokes about pot like every other man film in the world? It never is. It always has to be about, oh my god, so-and-so cheated on me, but my best friend said this, and now we fell out, and let's get married and have children and shit. And, I just feel that a more realistic approach would have been if Meg Ryan had bitch-slapped Eva Mendes and then, I don't know, put laxative in her husband's coffee every day for a year until he shit his brains out or something. I think that would have been more logical than to just be faring about whatever she is doing. I can't remember what she did.
So, there you have it. There's an opinion from Anne Girls.
Thank you very much, ladies. It's very much appreciated.
Ta, girls. And just to bring it down a little bit, if in any way, shape or form we've shocked, disturbed, angered, annoyed or vexed any of you because of our choice of film to review this week, then we wholeheartedly apologise from the bottom of our hearts. So, to make up for this abomination, here's a little sneak peek of what we're going to review next time we meet. That's gonna be dead good, that is. It's got explosions and fire and ass in it.
Yes.
That makes things
so
good.
So join us, won't you? So thanks very much, and we'll see you next time.
Toast!